What did you know about what happened here?
Nothing. Nothing at all. They kept the gates locked so I couldn't go back. I didn't go back to none of them campers. I didn't even know that there was an Isaac. I didn't know nothing until my granddaughter ran away and told it all.
That was earlier this month, right?
That was not Haley.
Month. No,
that
it was in Haley. October.
That was Haley.
October.
Haley is the one that ran away and told the cops. And I was got to thank for 3 years. They lived back there, and I didn't know if there was a baby. I didn't know nothing.
It's hard to even believe this.
It is. It's about to kill me.
What can you tell us about your son, Dad?
He didn't want to work. Neither one of them should have ever been parents because they didn't take care of them right.
When you brought that up to them, and I'm sure you did, what did they tell you?
They don't pay attention to what you say. They don't. But Dan kept that gate locked. That gate locked. And them woods up there against the garage. So I couldn't see. And if I went to go out there, one of his granddaughters ran out ahead of me to tell him I was coming, so if he had Isaac out, he'd get him put away. He threatened them girls if they told me he would kill them. He threatened them. That's why they ran away.
What do you mean by if he had Isaac out?
Isaac out in the yard.
Oh, okay.
Out in the yard, back there.
And which one of those garage buildings did he have the other remains?
What do you mean, honey?
Well, they found a number of them.
Here? Did they find them here?
They found some bones here, yeah.
Where?
Huh?
Where?
In one of those garages. That's what I was asking you.
We don't know anything.
One day I came home, and there was 15 police cars here dinging up my backyard, my back garage. And said they found nothing. My husband, and I don't know if this has killed my husband, because my husband, they came back in May of 2005. And in 2005 in November, my husband passed away. Had a massive heart attack. And when I heard this from Haley about there being an Isaac and everything, I made up my mind I sell it. I went through a mortgage deal, and the day that Dan left me, I was to get $87,000 from the mortgage to help do my house. I can't do it by myself. So I canceled it. And I sold it for $55,000 to get away from it all.
Man, when you said that Daniel and her lived back there, what do you mean? Where did they live?
Campers.
In them campers.
In a camper. What do you mean? Like a travel trailer?
Yes.
Or? They're not back there now. Kenny got rid of them. They were nasty. And little Danny.
Delores, were they the sort of campers that go on the back of a pickup truck?
One was. The other one was with a motor.
Okay, so the other one's kind of an RV.
Yeah. But the motor he took out to put in the race car.
Where was Daniel's wife during the time that they lived back there?
She was here part of the time, but then she got talked with a lady from church, Ginger. Ginger's husband had just passed away, and Ginger was real bad. Linda knew about medicine, and Linda left to go be with them, with her. She'd come back once in a while, not every day. But poor little Danny was left out in that camper. I couldn't go out to her. And when people would come to the house, they'd say she was sick. But it wasn't she was sick. She had head lice so bad that you could see them when she bent her head down.
That was his wife?
That was the little Danny.
Oh. All right, so who actually lived in this main house?
Me. Aunt Terry, their oldest daughter. I have Monsignor Gravis. I get choked very easily. And Terry moved in there to be with me. So if I needed help.
So, some of this was happening while you were living here in the main house.
Well, I was in the house. And I didn't know it. I didn't even know that girl was pregnant. To me, I think I'm kind of dumb to know that these things happened. And I didn't know about it.
Did you have any suspicions?
Nothing. Nothing. Teresa Carmichael can tell you. When we went to Ginger's and she gave Linda the write-up on what Haley said, she said, Delores, you need to see it. And when I seen Isaac, 3 years old, I liked to lost it. Because I didn't know it. I did not know it. At all.
Did Ashley ever say anything to you?
No. They were all told not to. They were all told, even when they lived in Oklahoma, they were told to tell that they had a nice home and everything, but they didn't. They lived in trailers. They've lived in trailers because they've been on the run. Dan's run from Social Security. Dan's run from everything.
Do you know if Daniel molested the other children?
And I do love him because he's my son.
He's accused now of some terrible things.
But I can't go along with him for what he's done. Just because I'm a mother. And I had that feeling. But I can't go along with what he has done. I don't know what else to say.